Well, I think in Libya, you're seeing signs of the rebels themselves infighting. Even before Gaddafi steps down, while this stalemate is going on, you've had the assassination of the former Minister of Interior, currently the head of the rebels' armed forces, assassinated, and there's now infighting between their own forces before Gaddafi even leaves. So it's very much in a state of war, very much still about the vengeance and who is who and who is loyal to who. In Libya and generally in the region. I think when you look at Egypt, it's a very different story than when you look at Libya or Syria. Here in Egypt, you had a dictator that was propped up by the United States. Billions of dollars of aid came here, and in the end, the military decided not to continue to support their boss, essentially, and stepped away from him. And because of that, he left power. Yes, it was a populist movement that pushed him out, but ultimately, if the military didn't take sides with the protesters here in Egypt, they wouldn't have left. If the West didn't have so much influence on the leadership, it may have been a different picture. And in Syria and in Libya, that influence really does nothing. Denouncing does nothing because they weren't allies in the first place.
So does it look like a protracted civil war to you?
In Libya, yes. I think it's a protracted civil war. It's been going on a long time, and it became quite clear quite quickly that this was not going to be unarmed protesters forever, that they had bled so much. They were taking up arms to fight the fight, and that fight is continuing to this point, and even with airstrikes, there's no sign that he has any intention of leaving.
And what do you make of this report in the New York Times today that Gaddafi's son is seeking rebel allies? He said in an hour-long interview that he was reversing course to forge a secret alliance with radical Islamist elements among the Libya rebels.
I mean, it sounds like petulance, I think, more than anything, but I think it's also a tactic to scare the West. You know, Saif al-Islam, I mean, you know, Gaddafi himself and Saif al-Islam to a degree, the rhetoric coming out of Tripoli feels it's almost unhinged to a certain degree. And I think this is a government, a very beleaguered, very besieged government that's flailing around trying to seek any kind of leverage, intimidation, or fears. I think the Islamists so far in Libya have made very clear that they want to be part of the opposition. There has been no talk about, you know, trying to seize control of the state. They've been working, you know, within a, let's be frank, it's not a very cohesive opposition.
Join us online at charlierose.com.